Anne. I am back with part two of Howl's Moving Castle. So this, of course, is the interior, and I'm really, really excited to share this with you. I know that it looks extraordinarily small at this point, but what was actually happening was it started to get bigger as we started to go up the floors, and there was actually a lot of space here. And what I really like about it is how I would imagine the castle to actually look. I actually think that it wasn't that far off on the interior. Of course, I didn't want to go overboard and do exact replica rooms of what we've seen. And I didn't want to do this because I wanted to use my own creative ideas and also just use inspiration from the film, but not copy anything, because anybody can copy. Anybody can think, okay, there's a chair there, I need to put a chair there, fireplace there, fireplace there. But what I did was I did something different and I made it my own, and I really like that. I know that some people will have mixed opinions on the interior, but of course that's always going to happen. My interior builds are always the ones that get the most criticism out of everything I do, LPs, exteriors, just any video that I share, it's always the interiors that people do disagree on a little bit more. But that was the lounge in here. So what I decided to do was I wanted to have the doorway, of course. I couldn't have it so that it was on odd levels because I would have loved to have had that. Have the fireplace slightly higher up on a little bit of a level there. And I would have also had the door maybe sinking down, because that's pretty accurate to how it actually is in the film and also in the book, I believe. I believe it's a book. I haven't read the book. But yeah, so this is the study in here. The study was just an ordinary room. We don't actually see a lot of this in the film, and this is really just from imagination from this point onwards. What I would imagine, there is a scene when Howl is in the bath, not in a weird way, but I actually think that it's when he's recovering from something, and I would imagine the bath to maybe be in the centre of a room. And it would look very old-fashioned, but it would also look very steampunky, keeping the brown sort of theme going throughout, and also the stone, lots and lots of stone used throughout the build. I used the steampunky staircases and I made them quite grand, but in the way that it's not a grand entrance, nothing that you'd see in one of my celebrity mansions or, I don't know, Disney mansions, anything like that. It's just not going to look that way. And the reason is because I wouldn't imagine it to. I'd imagine this house very narrow, very crooked, and if it has something in a weird place, and that would just be how it would be left. And it's going to be a cluttered house more than anything. I don't think that they would have staff, but then again, Sophie's quite neat. She does actually tidy the house during the end. I don't know. I still think that it does have the sense of being filled with things, like it's been lived in for a very long time. Maybe they've just got so many family artifacts that they want to keep in the build, and that is why it looks this way. But what we were doing at this point is we were moving up to, I think, one of the biggest floors that we do actually have. And what I was doing on this floor is I was putting in a lounge. Well, I was going to put in a lounge. I was actually figuring out the layout of this build. It's going to be a little bit topsy-turvy as well. So I wanted to have it maybe being a little bit of an upside-down house. I'm actually really into that at the moment. I think it's a really cool, unique idea. And I just love the idea of thinking about Howl's Moving Castle being that way, because I don't think that it would be all pretty and perfect on the inside. I actually think it would be very topsy-turvy, narrow, maybe some parts would be claustrophobic. And also, it would, of course, feel quite magical. I also did want to incorporate lots and lots of fireplaces on the build. So I think on every single floor, there's at least one fireplace somewhere. And that's because I think his name is, I can't remember, it begins with a C. I think. He's the fire. Calcifer, that's it, Calcifer. He's the fire that keeps the whole place running, and he is just a really cool character in himself. And he's a fire demon, which isn't a nice way to look at it, but it's actually quite nice having a different twist on a demon not being so bad after all. And I like that. He's a little bit mischievous, but he's funny and he's great in the film. I love him to bits. But yeah, so I did, because I wanted to include a little bit there of the storyline, so maybe Calcifer would be in the fireplace talking to them. You could even create a Calcifer sim if you wanted to. He could be very fiery. You could also use some custom content if you're into that sort of stuff, and you could have maybe fire surrounding him. You can have all that sort of stuff when you include custom content, so that could be pretty interesting. This room in here would be what I would imagine Howl and Sophie's bedroom to look like. I also wanted to put in lots of guest rooms, because I would definitely imagine lots and lots of bedrooms in this build. I think 4 was the number that I went for in the end, and that was including children's bedrooms as well, because I would love, love, love to imagine that they had a family in the end, maybe a big family of like 4 or 5 children. I would love that to bits, and that would just be amazing. I would love a Howl's Moving Castle too. I wish they'd do it. And I think that would be a really cool thing. But I mean, yeah, I definitely imagine that there'd be more children running about the house and it would be a really happy place. A little bit crazy at times, but yeah, definitely a fun place to be and very family orientated and happy. This was the lounge. The lounge was actually a very big room. I can't remember what I put in here in the end. I was actually on the phone whilst I was making this. I was talking to my best friend and we were going over some wedding stuff and she was really worried about what's going on at the moment. I've had a couple of dramas and I think mainly the drama that I'm putting up with at the moment to do with my wedding is the fact that a lot of the people that I have hired to do certain things aren't keeping their ends of the bargain or they're not appearing to keep their ends of the bargain. So for instance, when I've ordered something, let's say for example it's the cake, my wedding cake, then I'll pay the money for it and I just won't hear back from the people for ages and they just won't like get back to me. And that's terrifying. That's absolutely petrifying. So yeah, I was thinking then on the phone and I was trying to multitask. It's also really fun though, because I always feel happy when I speak to her. And I think as well, I think I just am in a lot of a better mood, like when I'm speaking on the phone to people. It also keeps me distracted. And because we were having a bit of a laugh about what's happening and stuff and trying to sort things out, I don't know, it was really therapeutic to, of course, do this at the same time. So I did put a television in the house and I put that in because even though I wouldn't imagine the house itself to have that many televisions, I think for this build, I would really, really want that. And for the family's needs sake, I just think it would be a really interesting area. I do actually think there is a television in the film that I've watched because when they're listening to the news, I think they must have to watch it on the television because by newspaper, I can't imagine that would work. So I think somewhere they do have a television. It might actually be downstairs by the fireplace, but I have no idea. Up here was another place for rooms. I actually put the kitchen up here, I think. That was something that I definitely wanted to have, being a bit topsy-turvy, maybe a bit hidden away. I also wanted to use a lot of space for it. I wanted to have a steampunky cookie machine as well. That would be a really cool thing to have in the kitchen, I'd imagine. I also put in a baby's room next to it. So this area up here was for the kitchen, the baby's area, and it was also the last staircase leading up to the last floor. I did the picnic area last. So the balcony that you can see just off of this room, that was the part that I worked on last. And that is because I wanted to make it super, super special. I wanted to have lots and lots of time to think about what I was going to do with that area. And I think that by doing that and actually leaving it for a little bit, was actually the best choice because running through the builds and decorating it all made sure that I had plenty of ideas left for that part. I was also putting some fireplaces round and I think as well I did forget about that door because it really did blend in very nicely with the paint that I was using or the panelling rather. I used a lot of spooky stuff pack things and that's because I do actually like to use the packs and I do realise that for some people buying the spooky stuff pack was a moment thing. And we can't really use it very much afterwards. So I do actually like to use a lot of it in my build because I think that the wood texture that we got from it is absolutely beautiful. I do use it with a lot of my mansions as well, just because it goes so nicely with everything. It's just one of my favorite things. So yeah, I did. I also put some bookcases in because I forgot about those quite a lot actually. I was just so distracted with putting other things in that the bookcases weren't even a major thing for me. And I think I did finish off the area just by putting in an easel or bushes, just things that they can do, which would really make sure that they would have interesting things to keep them occupied. And also for careers, I don't know what they would do. I don't think that they would have to work. I think that Sophie might want to work. So she might actually go back to the hat shop that she once worked in and maybe run things the way that she would want to. Or they could try and sell some of the things that the castle actually dropped in the movie. So towards the end, of course, it's had a bit of a failure with Calcifer. And I think after that, it came back and that's when it was floating at the end and it was really cool and it was all good. No spoilers. To be completely honest though, as much as I love the film, I sometimes had no idea what the heck was going on, even though I thoroughly enjoyed every single moment of it. But I do actually think that maybe they would want to resell some of those things that the castle dropped, and that could be their way of giving back to the community. So if you did want The Sims to have a career, if you did want to reenact Hal and Sophie's love story, or have The Sims living here, then maybe you could actually create a junk shop, which would be bits and bobs. And that might actually be a really interesting career path for them. Of course, if you do, I would love to know how you decide to use it in the end. Maybe you want to use a completely different family. I don't know. This was a kitchen though, so the kitchen had a nice square in the middle for the guests to sit, and they would just sit around. This would be their seating area. Instead of a dining room, I thought that it would just be better to make the kitchen a little bit bigger, because that would also mean that I could include the cookie steampunk machine, and that would be interesting to have in the back there, so I definitely wanted to include that in. I did, of course, put a fireplace in here to keep the warmth in the kitchen. I'm not sure if the kitchen would actually need it, because kitchens are usually quite warm, especially with the stove on, things like that. I don't know. That was the bathroom there. I hardly did anything in there, and the reason is because I didn't want to fill it up too much, because there wasn't actually enough room there for me to do much. This was a children's bedroom up here again, so I did actually use a bedroom downstairs for the children, and that would be for the babies, I think. But yeah, maybe there would be a child up here that wouldn't particularly get on with the other siblings too well, or maybe this would be the magical child that was dealing with the magical powers separately. I don't know. That's what I would imagine. But I think that this is an interesting room because it could be used for lots of different things. It could also be used for bits and bobs, junk. You could change it into whatever you wanted to change it into. I just wasn't really sure at this point. I was trying to think about the best way that I could possibly design it. But honestly, it just wasn't working for me. I also had to make sure that the room was completely accessible by every single angle. So it was actually possible for the Sims to walk up here and they wouldn't get stuck in between that screw, which was, of course, overly enlarged. But I did test it and it turned out that it was absolutely fine, so that shouldn't be an issue at all. That was the bedroom finished off, and this was actually my favourite part of the whole build. I love this area so much. In fact, if I'd have had my time over again, I think me being a perfectionist and not liking to get things wrong, I think I would have made it circular, because I think circular would have been better. But instead, I made it this shape because it still looked nice. I think circular might have been an issue anyway, which would have been an issue with the floors and stuff, and I don't know. It would have got super complicated. This was a picnic area though, so this is where I would imagine the family to all sit down. And I think I've mentioned this a couple of times, but it's actually in the film itself, or at least it was a fan-made picture that I saw. I have no idea. I think I do remember something a little bit like this in the end, when Sophie's holding a hat and they're just floating off, and it's just so cute. Oh my gosh, I've nearly got a tear in my eye just thinking about it. But I did put a picnic basket there, and I also put some candles and things because it would be super romantic. I would absolutely love to go here. It would just be so amazing, and it is a really romantic place as well. I mean, it is steampunk, of course, but it is still a really, really beautiful venue, and this could be amazing for weddings and things. If you did want to have a little bit of a strange wedding, then it would be really fun to have it here. But that is the end of the build, so I really hope that you enjoyed it, and I hope to see your future videos. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll speak to you all soon.